Welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be doing a wig transformation with Big Chop Hair using this kind of kinky 18 inch front lace wig, and it is kind of like a 3B3C texture. It is a full front lace wig with three clips in the back and two adjustable straps, and then two clips in the front, and the lace goes from ear to ear so you can part it throughout your entire front of your head. So I'm first going to start by bleaching this hair. So I'm going to, of course, use a bowl and a spatula, and I'm going to be using a 30 volume developer and, of course, some enlightener. And I'm going to be using this on a mannequin head to color it first. You can buy a mannequin head for about $2-3 at the beauty supply store, along with a mannequin head holder, and that's about $9.99 at the store. And you're going to take these little push pins to make sure that the wig is secure on the mannequin head. And so as you can see, it is a 1B. It's a really, really pretty curl. It's very soft, and the wig is extremely lightweight. So I did not anticipate that this is going to take a long time to color, but it did take some technique and timing, and I'll show you guys as we progress with the video. So I'm gonna mix the bleach with the developer. Make sure that you put equal parts and just mix it until you get a very smooth, consistent base. And I will tell you, this stuff is very strong, so if you are not used to this type of smell, make sure that you're in a very ventilated area. And so you're just going to take some foil. The reason why I decided to use foil is because it heats up the hair faster, which means it's going to process faster. And so what I wanted to do is start midway and working my way down, because I did not want to ombre it like you normally would see it on a lot of different videos. I wanted to do it kind of a different way, only because it processed so fast. As I was processing the hair, it began to lift immediately. I'll show you guys in a second. So I would say about halfway through this process, the hair was already starting to lift. So what I had to do halfway is start to remove the foil. As you can see, the color turned a really pretty golden blonde. So I rinsed it out, I removed it, and I washed it out. I did not put any shampoo or conditioner in it because I knew that I was going to go back in with the bleach at the top of the hair. So as you can see, I'm starting to ombre it, and I'm using a balayage method where I'm just taking it and I'm just kind of applying it with the spatula. Well, I don't know if this is necessarily considered balayage, but I am just applying with the spatula. But this time I'm not going to apply the foil because I want it to process a little bit slower. So I just kind of worked that through a little bit to kind of really play up the gradual effects on it. Once I washed that out, I went back in with a color treated conditioner. You can use any type of conditioner that you would like. I will list the conditioner that I used below. And so I basically just deconditioned it with the conditioner, and I made sure that I definitely saturated it because bleach will dry your wig out. Although it did loosen it a little bit, it did not damage the integrity of the curl. After I let it dry a little bit, I begin to cut the lace. You want to make sure that you're not cutting the little baby hairs that it came with, and you want to make sure that you're not cutting straight across because, like I said, it's a front lace, so it's built like your forehead would. So it has little halves where your temples go, and then it's straight across where your forehead is. So that took a little bit because I wanted to make sure that I did not mess that up. As you can see, I have my hair twisted back, nothing special. You can cornrow it back, twist it back, whatever. Before I put on my wig cap, I'm just going to test out the wig to see how it fits. And this is me kind of securing the three clips in the back and then the two clips on the side, just to see. So now I'm just going to go in and cut it. And I knew that I wanted a bang, So I twisted it and I kind of made my bang and just kind of cut it along and framed my face. I did not want to cut too much just in the front. I didn't really cut any in the back. I just kind of trimmed it along the sides. With this process, you want to take your time. You do not want to cut too much off because once it's gone, it's gone. It's not your hair. So just really make sure that you cut as little as possible first and then kind of go in and adjust as needed. I'm going to take the diffuser to dry it before I finish the cutting process. And once that is done, I'm also going to take a powder brush just to kind of see what it's going to look like fully dry. And as you can see, it's turning into a really, really pretty shape. It's shaped exactly how I liked it. So since I'm not going to sew the wig in the front where the lace is around the perimeter of my head, I'm going to take some additional bobby pins just to secure it a little bit more as I'm going to go in and begin to one curl it. And so for the tool that I use for the one curls, I don't remember. I'm going to have to list that below in the description box. It has like these little ridges and it holds the hair in place. The only thing with that is it'll begin to snag if you're not careful. And so since the hair is very curly, what I did was, and this was off camera, I went in with a flat iron and I flat ironed the roots because the roots were very, very curly and I wanted this to be a very, very sleek look. So you could either blow dry your roots out or you could just flat iron your roots out. I just flat ironed it really, really quickly. And then the rest was smoothed out by the curling wand. So now I'm just going to go in with some edge control. You can use any edge control, y'all. Just use your favorite. And just go in just to lay your sides down. I'm going to use a toothbrush just to kind of slick my sides down a little bit. And then I'm going to go in and take a really dark matte eyeshadow. And I'm going to go over where the lace is in the front. And I'm going to wear my hair pushed off so my baby hair is in the front and the wig is kind of like a little bit off. So it looks natural if the wind lifts my hair up off of my head. And now I'm just going to go in with a wide tooth comb just to kind of style it and give it a little bit more volume. And that is it. I absolutely love this wig. I hope that you guys enjoyed this tutorial. There is a promo code in the description box for you guys to save on this unit. So until next time, don't forget to please rate, comment, and subscribe. See you guys later. Peace.